What is up, YouTube? It's your boy Zuko the Flame Prince back with another video. In this one, I'll be reacting to the second song on the Death of Slim Shady. This one is titled Habits. So, without any further ado, let's jump right in.
Been waiting a long time for this shit. Long time no see. Thought you got rid of my ass, huh? Alright, here's what we're gonna do. You take this, or I put a bullet between your fucking eyes. Here. We'll split it. No. Half in that a van, I'm driving straight at a van. In a black sedan, fast as I can. In Pakistan, getting chased by Pakistans. You know how I roll, bitch, I'm an avalanche. It's my shit, I'm gonna spit it how I wanna spit it. Whoever gets offended, suck a dick and fuck a critic. About to get retarded on this motherfucking shit.
You can't say me, say retarded.
Shut up, midget, shut up, midget. Trying to break the habit of saying any R words. But I'm still an addict, so it's getting harder. Been calling bitches hoes since a kindergarten. PC court with a shitty lawyer, like damn.
You got an addiction, man. I know you can't rid of me forever.
I don't know if I wanna listen through it throughout like I did with Renaissance, because that was a relatively short song. So I think with this one I'll just go verse by verse like I usually do. I was trying to understand, so in the first song he spat on his grave, right? I don't know if that was him spitting or just someone spitting on the grave of Slim Shady, right? And then it sounded like there was a shovel or someone getting out of the dirt at the start of this, but I could have been mishearing. Because I don't know who this gentleman he's talking to is. If it was the grave thing I'm visualizing, then did he get out of his grave and take the Undertaker ransom? Is that what's going on? Not sure.
Here, we'll split it. Half in that a van, I'm driving straight at a van. In a black sedan, fast as I can. In Pakistan, getting chased by Pakistans. You know how I roll, bitch, I'm an avalanche.
So I'm guessing an Ativan is a type of drug. Half an Ativan, I'm driving straight at a van in a black sedan, fast as I can. So that's like the... I was thinking of Going Bad music video with Drake and Meek Mill, but also in... Bad versus Evil, and he had a bar saying that him and Royce will drive cars straight to each other and then we'll see who will be a bitch and swerve first. I think that's a callback to that, because the last album I did before this was the Slim Shady LP. Yeah, those references, if there's any here, I think will probably be fresher still in my mind. But this is also giving rhyming for rhyming's sake, because I'm in a van, driving straight at a van in a black sedan in Pakistan, getting chased by a pack of stans. You know how I roll, bitch, I'm an avalanche.
Avalanche. It's my shit, I'm gonna spit it how I wanna spit it. Whatever gets offended, suck a dick and fuck a critic. About to get retarded on this motherfucking shit.
So this is my shit, I'm gonna spit it how I wanna spit it. Your wife or kids offended, suck a dick and fuck a critic. About to get retarded on this motherfucking shit. You can't say retarded, shut up, midget. So I think both of those, the R word, well, now has become very derogatory. Back then, used to just mean stupid, but now it's been assigned to, like, special kids. I believe midget is also now considered derogatory, because, again, back then, it used to just be synonymous with short. But with time, I guess this is just the increased sensitivity that people have towards certain words. But Eminem doesn't like that. It feels like his speech is being policed. This is his shit. He's gonna spit it how he wants to.
Dick and fuck a critic. About to get retarded on this motherfucking shit.
You can't say retarded.
Shut up, midget. Shut up, midget. Trying to break the habit of saying any R words. But I'm still an addict, so it's getting harder. Been calling bitches hoes since a kindergarten. This is Jimmy Carter. Now I'm kitty cornered. Sitting in PC court with a shitty lawyer.
I've been trying to break the habit of saying any R words. So obviously there's the one he just said twice before. Retarded. And then I can't think of any other R-words Eminem says besides rape, which even that you can't say on this platform, right? That's why like a lot of creators, when they speak about it to avoid demonetization, they call it grape. Or if they're talking about like the hub, they call it corn, and just to avoid YouTube's demonetization shit. Been trying to break the habit of saying any R-words, but I'm still an addict, so it's getting harder. So he said harder as if it's going to be hard R, but he's not going to say the N-word, so I think I could just be reaching there. Been calling bitches hoes since a kid at Gardner. But now I'm cornered sitting in PC courts. Well, what does PC mean? Politically correct, right? Sitting in PC courts with a shitty lawyer, like, damn. Is being taken to courts for all his slurs and shit that he'd be saying in his raps.
Like, damn.
You got an addiction, man. I know you can't get rid of me forever, cause you know that I'm prescription, man. God damn, I miss you, Slim. You got an addiction, man. I know you can't get rid of me forever, cause you know that I'm prescription, man. Next time I'll be in your van.
It's just a kid from Detroit who knew how to
It's a white girl's hook. You got an addiction, man. You can't get rid of me forever. Because you know that I'm prescription, man. Goddamn, I miss you, Slim. Okay, so he threw me for a loop now. I thought White Gold was Slim talking to Marshall saying, you're addicted to me and this out there persona. You can't get rid of me. But if he says, I miss you, Slim, so he's not Slim, he could just be drugs, maybe. Because that would make literal sense with the I'm your prescription, Slim, because Slim is obviously the drug-induced hyperbolic version of Marshall and his imagination. You got an addiction. I know you can't get rid of me forever because you know that I'm prescription. So this is also, it's reminding me of like relapse. In that sense, like he's again relapsing back into this character of Slim Shady, which requires the drugs that I think White Gold is rapping from the perspective of.
I know you can't get rid of me forever because you know that I'm prescription. Next time I'll be your
I was just a kid from Detroit who knew how to destroy the booth and had a point to prove. In a missile, venomous still I poison youth sentences. I'm pinning art just a toy with you, which is a joy to do. Slim is just a lyricist, hidden voices, true sentiments. Got the women pissed and it seems like men are just off growing a huge clitoris. Pussies, yeah, probably annoyed a few feminists. I reminisce on them blowing a fuse over my point of view. Still I'm devoid of two shits to give. My thinking is primitive, but when it comes to giving it to anybody, boy is Bruce generous. And I'm not as much of a boy is Bruce Jenner is. Cause I'm not a boy, I'm a man, bitch. Man, bitch. My speech is free, it's his choice to choose gender is man. This shit is like opioid abuse, isn't it? Yeah.
You got an addiction, man.
Are these 16s? They seem a bit short. Cause with two verses in, like only a minute or some change in, and he's already gone through two verses. So I don't know if this is gonna be like five verses or four verses in the song, or if there's gonna be like a beat switch somewhere.
Yeah. Was just a kid from Detroit who knew how to destroy the booth and had a point to prove. In a missile, venomous still I poison youth sentences. I'm pinning art just a toy with you, which is a.
Obviously, I'm relying on lyric videos for these, but it sounds like these people are getting lyrics wrong. I'm just going to give them the benefit of the doubt because if I don't have the energy to be correcting people who make lyric vids. Was just a kid from Detroit who knew how to destroy the booth and had a point to prove. Still, I poison you. Sentences I'm pinning just to toy with you. I don't know. I feel like, well, there's nothing he's saying here that makes me think of that. But sentences could be like jail sentences, pen in like a penitentiary, because he was in the court with the lawyer at the end of the first verse, but could be reaching there.
Point to do, Slim is just a lyricist, hear the voices, true sentiments. Got the women pissed and it seems like men are just off-growing a huge clitoris. Pussies, yeah, probably annoyed a few feminists. I reminisce on them blowing up.
Slim is just the lyricist, hear the voices, true sentiments. Got the women pissed and it seems like men are just off-growing a huge clitoris. Because they're becoming feminized. Yeah, probably annoyed a few feminists. I reminisce on them blowing a fuse over my points and views.
So from my point of view, still I'm devoid of two shits to give. My thinking is primitive, but when it comes to giving it to anybody, boy is Bruce generous, and about as much of...
Eminem has a lot of names, right? Is Bruce one of Eminem's names? Like government names, I think it might be. Still I'm devoid of two shits to give. My thinking is primitive, so outdated. Because we're in 2024 and half the shit he was saying, people are trying to cancel him for. That's why he's in the cancel court. But when it comes to giving it to anybody, boy, is Bruce generous. I think Bruce is Eminem with this instance, but also Bruce Jenner, anybody, because I believe they transitioned from Bruce to, is it Caitlyn? Yeah, but I believe Bruce Jenner transitioned. So anybody, male or female, anybody. Boy is Bruce generous, and I'm about as much of a boy as Bruce Jenner is, because I'm not a boy, I'm a man, bitch. And then he explains it by saying man, bitch. My speech is free, it's his choice to choose genderless. This shit is like opiate abuse, isn't it?
On them blowing a fuse, over my point of view, still I'm devoid of two shits to give. My thinking is primitive, but when it comes to giving it to anybody, boy is Bruce generous, and I'm about as much of a boy as Bruce Jenner is. Cause I'm not a boy, I'm a man, bitch. My speech is free, it's his choice to choose genderless. Man. This shit is like opioid abuse, isn't it? Yeah.
You got an addiction, man.
So when he says this shit is like opiate abuse, what is he referring to? The freedom to say whatever the fuck he wants? Or what is he referring to there?
I know you can't get rid of me forever cause you know that I'm prescription, man. God damn, I miss you, son. You got an addiction, man. I know you can't get rid of me forever cause you know that I'm prescription, man. Next time I'll be your bitch.
There's times when I lay down to sleep, I argue with myself. Am I the only one who things is way too, I need help. Just a little bit, know a lot of it, I really, really gotta quit. Something's wrong with me, my God. Old habits die hard.
There's times when I lay down to sleep and argue with myself. Am I the only one who thinks it's weird? Do I need help? Just a little bit. No, a lot of it. I really, really gotta quit. Something's wrong with me. My God, old habits die hard. So old habits, he's addicted to the Slim persona, but also he's addicted to drugs. That's the only, because I don't understand the hook. If he's not referring to drugs whatsoever, and he's not rapping from the perspective of Slim, then I don't get the hook. But I'll say his habits that are dying hard is the Slim persona and his drugged out zany, non-give-a-fuck things that he wants to say. But also, this being the first, like, official song, I guess this is presenting the conflict that is going to be laid in throughout this entire album of Marshall arguing with Slim, who is still a part of his psyche and still part of the person he is.
I need help, just a little bit, know a lot of it, I really, really gotta quit. Something's wrong with me, my God, old habits die hard.
Look at you, what's the matter with you people? You're sad that people are mean? Well, I'm sorry, the world isn't one big liberal arts college campus. You, no pricks.
Mom shaming, dad shaming, yeah, fat shaming, mansplaining, blah. Cry babies, attack Shady. Wham, mad cause they can't tame me. They come to censors like the Avengers, and they assemble like prince and intern. A word like ginger into the N-word. All these pronouns I can't remember. They of them theirs, his or him hers. Into them girls who bought tits to get attention, then get hit on by ugly men who are not in your league, so you pretend you're a victim and meet torn. Outrage, how fake. Nowadays some gals they just clout chase. Look at me with sour grapes and your brow raised. Bitch, you ain't about head, about face. Little white middle age, upper middle class, with a glass of wine and your cigarette. Bitch, get off the internet. You ain't even fed your kids dinner yet. Parental discretion, mental aggression. My head's a Smith and Wesson. You're messing with a lethal weapon like an evil stepdad. I got an infrared like a ginger stepkid who pissed the bed. I do this shit in jest and it's just a mess. And I put your head. And if men wanna wear lipstick and women's underwear, who cares? This shit is their business, not bare. Witness beware, bitches to blare. Which are you scared? Bitches, some surreptitious and square business. Just attack my therapist with a pair of scissors like Merry Christmas dressed as a hairy Christian terrorist with the hair trigger. With these buttons I'm always pushing, pain I'm always inflicting. Protesters outside the Shady office is living. It'll make you think that you had the game unlocked till they pick it. Only way for me to explain it is I'm conflicted. Walking on eggshells like if I take it too far, is this it? Part of me gets it and wants to say I'm sorry and fix it. So all my statements are basically contradictive. Like using the F word for gay is wrong and offensive. And insensitive is if me saying the R word isn't.
Wait a minute, which R word? Rape or retarded, did it?
Not you.
Would this rhyme be okay if Sly Parker did it?
Okay, screw you guys.
Would it make you less angry if Carbon spit it?
God damn it.
And as far as what I just stated regarding midgets, you'll probably think I'll just say that I'm playing. I'm not a minted.
Yeah.
Swear to God, I see one of them little fuckers come at me. I'm picking up by his legs and dropping and kicking. Marshall, your wicked face that you are addicted. But they gon' do me the same as the baby with all of this shit. What? Chappelle and Colin, they're calling Shady misogynistic while raising $3 to graduated from college with honor. Summa cum laude, my sense of humor is probably twisted. It's painfully obvious.
You had an addiction, man. I know you can't get rid of me.
So that third verse, because I was worried why the other verses were so short. So he really just got shit off his chest on that one. The R word, I also wasn't sure which one he was talking about between, well, I had an idea, but I also figured rape could be in that conversation, and he knew what he was doing, so I guess I have to give credit to him there. And I think it just makes sense, given what I've heard from his discography, that that would be the R word as well. Mom shaming and dad shaming, yeah, fat shaming, man, explaining, blah. Cry babies attack Shady, wah, which is a baby cry sound. Mad because they can't tame me. Here come the censors like the Avengers. When they assemble like Prince and then turn, Prince the artist, and then turn a word like ginger into the N-word. Okay, so that's, I'm not aware of that. It's probably something going on in white America, I would not know.
Cause they can't tame me. They come to censors like the Avengers, and they assemble like Prince and intern. A word like ginger into the N-word. All these pronouns I can't remember. They of them theirs, his or him hers. Into them girls who bought tits to get attention, then get hit on by ugly men who are not in your league, so you pretend you're
All these pronouns I can't remember. They of them theirs, his or him hers. and to them girls that bought tests to get attention. Then get hit by ugly men who are not in your league, so you pretend you're a victim and meet Tom.
Dumb and meet Tom. How rage, how fake. Nowadays some gals, they just clout chase. Look at me with sour grapes and your brow raised. Bitch, you ain't about head, about face. Little white middle age, upper middle class with a glass.
Bitch, you ain't about head, about face. I think about face is a military term, right? To tell someone to like face you straight on. But you ain't about head, you ain't about giving blowjobs, I guess is what it means there. Little white middle-aged upper middle class with a glass of wine in your cigarette. Okay, so he's describing a Karen there.
Wine in your cigarette, get off the internet.
You mean terminally online Karen.
Fed your kids dinner, yes. Parental discretion, mental aggression. My head's a Smith and Wesson. You're messing with a lethal weapon like an evil stepdad. I got an infrared like a ginger step kid who kissed the bed. I do this shit in chess and it's just a mess in it.
You ain't even fed your kids dinner yet. Parental discretion, mental aggression. My head's a Smith and Wesson. You're messing with the lethal weapon like an evil stepdad. I got an infrared like the ginger step kid who pissed the bed. So is he the step kid in this scenario with an evil stepdad? Because it's making me think of my mom again on relapse. No, not my mom. Is it insane? The one where his stepdad assaults him by a shed. I do this shit in jest and just to mess up with your head. I guess.
This shit is just, and it's just a mess in it. Put your head in a men wanna wear lipstick and women's underwear. Who cares? This shit is there. Business not bare. We just beware. Bitches to blare. Which one you scared? Bitches some surreptitious and square. Business just attack my therapist with a pair of scissors like Merry Christmas. Dressed as a hairy Christian terrorist with a hair trigger.
And if men wanna wear lipstick and women's underwear, who cares? The shit is there. Business not bare. Witness beware. Bitches the Blair Witch. Blair Witch is a... I'm pretty sure that's a horror movie. I don't watch horror movies, so I don't know the plot of that. Which might mean I don't get the rest of the scheme. The Blair Witch and you scare bitches. I'm surreptitious on square business. Just attacked my therapist with the pair of scissors like Merry Christmas. Dressed as a hairy Christian terrorist.
Terrorist with the hair trigger. Pulling these buttons, I'm always pushing. Pain, I'm always inflicting. Protesters outside the shady office is livid. It'll make you think that you have the game unlocked till it...
Protests outside the shady offices is livid. It'll make you think that you have the game unlocked till they picket. Until they picket. Picket fence. Protests. There's a tie in there. I feel like I've heard Eminem have this exact same thing about people writing outside shady offices, though. I think it's the way I am. So I don't know how I feel about it. It feels like it's retreading old ground, but whatever.
You think that you have the game unlocked till they pick it? Only way for me to explain it is I'm conflicted. Walking on eggshells like if I take it too far, is this it? Part of me gets it and wants to say I'm sorry and fix it.
I'm sorry.
So all my statements are basically contradicted. Like using the F word for...
Again, this is going back to what I assume is going to be the main conflict of this whole album, which is that Marshall is at odds with Slim Shady, who just doesn't give a fuck. Because he's conflicted walking on eggshells, like, if I take it too far, is this it? Will I get cancelled? Is this the end of my career? Part of me gets why people are upset, and I want to say sorry and fix it. And then the Shady voice, the devil on his shoulder, can't even bring themselves to apologize. They're like, I'm sorry, and then it cuts off. So all my statements are basically contradictive, like using the F word for gays is wrong and offensive.
It's wrong and offensive, and it's insensitive, visibly saying the hard word isn't. Wait a minute, which R word? Rape or retarded, midget?
Give it 5 years, midget is going to be the M word, and it's also not going to be cool to say M. Would this rhyme be okay if South Park had did it? Okay, screw you guys. Would it make you less angry if Cartman spit it? So there's a lot between these two bars that I think I could get into. First, I think he's Eminem is a big fan of Mr. Morale, the Big Steppers. Because even this argument he's having with us is similar to on Auntie Diaries, the conversation Kendrick had with his cousin, saying that it's fine, you can say the F word all you want, but only if you let white people, or the white girl in that instance, say the N-word. Just to show how to what the N-word is to black people or white people says it, that's the same sensitivity people who've transitioned have to, well, not queer people in general, that's the sensitivity they have towards the F-word being used towards them as a slur. Just to give, she said that just to give Kendrick some perspective. It's insensitive as me saying the R-word, isn't it? Wait a minute, which R-word? Rape or retarded midget? And then to go from that, this is like Eminem reminds me of an ignorant shit where Jay-Z is like, Scarface the movie did more than Scarface the rapper to me. So then blamed all the shit that's happened to me. The general point around that was, how are you going to try boycott me or cancel me or whatever when these ideas were fed to me via other media, like via other media outlets that you aren't trying to cancel. No one's trying to cancel Italian mafia movies, The Godfather and stuff. No one's trying to cancel Scarface, the movie, right? And movies about drug dealing. But when it's rappers doing it, all of a sudden it's a problem. It's the same shit Eminem is saying here. You're trying to cancel me for all these explicit adult jokes and everything in my humor. But if an adult cartoon like South Park did it, it would just be par for the course for them. And no one is canceling South Park. So I think that's the same disgruntlement Eminem has there. It's almost like a hypocrisy or a double standard.
Is it me saying the hard word? Is it wait a minute, which R word? Rape or retarded, midget?
Not you.
Would this rhyme be okay if South Park did it?
Okay, screw you guys.
Would it make you less angry if carbon spit it?
Yeah, damn it.
As far as what I just stated regarding midgets, you'll probably think I'm just saying that I'm playing, I'm not, I meant it.
Yeah.
Swear to God, I see one of them little fuckers come at me. I'll pick it up by his legs and drop it and kick it. Marshall, your wicked face that you are addicted, but they don't do me the same as the baby with all of this shit.
Watch.
Calling Shady, misogynistic, while raising $3, graduated from college with honors, summa cum laude, my sense of humor is probably twisted.
Marshall, you wicked, face it, you're addicted. Hey, these lyric videos. Face it, you're addicted. So, yes, Eminem is addicted to the Slim Shady persona and the freedom to say whatever the fuck he wants with no regards for how it makes anybody else feel. I think that's what he's addicted to, the Shady persona he's trying to bury. But they're gonna do me the same as DaBaby, who got cancelled for going against LGBTQ people, I believe. Chappelle and Colin, they're calling Shady misogynistic. Well, I don't know, that'd be kind of fucked if Chappelle is, because Chappelle says some misogynistic shit. No, he says some bigoted shit, I think is the term, not misogynistic. So I don't know if he's saying that Chappelle and Colin, whoever that is, are calling Shady misogynistic, or he's being lumped in with Chappelle and Colin, who are labels that themselves. So they're calling Shady misogynistic while raising three daughters, two of whom have already graduated from college with honors, summa cum laude. that's like the when you average a distinction. Is it 25%? 75%, I think, or 80%. Right, for a distinction. So you average that across all your modules that you took throughout your career. Summa cum laude, my sense of humor is probably twisted.
Painfully obvious.
You got an addiction, man. I know you can't get rid of me forever, cause you know that I'm prescription, man. God damn, I miss you, Sim. Hey, you got an addiction, man. I know you can't get rid of me forever, cause you know that I'm prescription, man. Next time I'll be in your veins.
I'm just playing, little people. You know I love you.
I'm just playing America. I'm just playing... Who else does it say? I'm just playing Diddy. You know I love you. That is another callback to one of the Eminem signatures, Vele. So after he shits on people for a bunch of bars, then he comes at the end to be like, hey, you know, I'm playing. This is in jest, of course. But yeah, man, that was my reaction to Habits. This video has no business being as long as it fucking is for a 4-minute, 5-minute song. I don't know. I think I need to speed up my talking points because this is ridiculous. Anyway, that was my reaction to Habits. If you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, share this video with other fans of Eminem you may know, but without it the way, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.